Okay, Missy.
Got issues with me?
Yep, eyes are watering.
I told you to leave it, Bubba.
And I thought to myself, who this little girl thinks she's telling anything to?
Enjoy your drink in peace. I ain't got no business with you right now.
What that mean?
For the last time, leave me alone.
Or what?
What's that?
Get the hell out of here before she kills us all.
You!
Get out of here.
John Marston!
It is good to see you.
I thought I heard a rumor you was alive. Jim Milton, that you?
Guess I didn't do a real good job of hiding my identity. We didn't hear nothing about you.
You kill a feller up by Roanoke?
Sure did.
I thought that sounded like you and Abigail and Jack. She's
fine.
She was always so kind to me.
I'm looking to buy us a property. Beecher's Hope, west of Blackwater. I'm kind of a farmer now. And you?
Oh, you know how it is. Bounties mostly and some other stuff, good and bad. Hey, you any interest in bounties?
I've gone straight. Huh? Sort of.
Oh, it's legal, usually.
Then... maybe.
Come on, then.
What? Where are we headed?
Strawberry. Guy on the run from New York. Good price for him.
What'd he do?
Rob a bank.
With a gun?
No, with a pan. He's an accountant, I think.
Sounds easy.
Got a bit of a ride.
I know. Your telegram. You said you had something to discuss. I didn't think we'd be chasing down an outlaw.
There's something else.
What?
Micah.
Micah?
I think so. I heard if someone sounded like him about a year back.
Okay.
We always said, if we found him...
I know what we said we'd do. That ain't changed.
I didn't think I'd see any of you again after you left for the Yukon.
Now we came back. Didn't strike it rich, as you can see.
But you're a rancher now.
I aim to be. Probably why I can't afford it. This country's becoming real civilized. That folk won't be around for long.
Thank you.
fine. Like I said, fella's name is Nathan Kirk, banker, bald, 45.
Okay.
You hit him that way. I'll meet you in a bit.
Hey, you. I'm looking for Nathan Kirk, a fella from New York. You got letters for him?
Who?
Nathan Kirk.
Threaten a post office worker. Punishable in some instances by up to 5 years imprisonment?
I'm looking for Nathan Kirk.
We haven't seen him, neither. Ask someplace else. Please?
You seen a fella? Fella from New York? Bald guy?
Yeah. A few New Yorkers come here in search of the West.
This one's a wanted man. I work for the government. Sort of. His name's Nathan Kirk.
Mr. Kirk? But he's so charming.
Is he staying here?
Up in room 3.
I'm gonna go pay him a visit. It's government business.
How exciting.
Mr. Kirk! Mr. Kirk, you in there?
Who is it?
Well, stop! Hey! That's Nathan Kirk! Oh! Got him?
Oh, shut up! Come on, jump on!
Come on, lady.
We gotta get after him. Remember, we want him alive, though.
No.
He went right!
Spooked, are you?
Please!
Let's see what you got in here. Thanks for that, Mr. Kirk. Real fun.
I'm an innocent man, but it's all a mistake. My wife is a desperate woman. How you buried, sir?
None of your business, woman.
Hey, quiet now.
Where shall I send the money? I ain't been paid yet.
Hold on to it for me. Need to speak to the bank over in Blackwater. Get a loan for the property. Might make them happy to see I've got a boss.
So I've got a couple of other leads I could use your help with if you're interested. I'm usually at the saloon in Blackwater.
I need money pretty bad, so I'll come find you.
Mister, in need of a ride?
Morning, partner. You want me to show you how to...
Oh, hell!
Careful now.
Excuse me, sir. Can I help you?
Yeah. I'm looking for Mr. Atherton. I'm a friend of Mr. Getty's over at Pronghorn Ranch.
Yeah, Mr. Atherton is in his office. Hey, please head in.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Please come in.
Don't hang me for it.
Look where you're going.
Can I help you?
I hope so. I want a loan, sir. A line of credit, so I can buy some property.
What property?
An old ranch, Beecher's Hope.
That old dump?
I know it ain't much, but I ain't much of a farmer either. But I will get there.
That is a very unusual way of asking for a loan. Mr.
Marston.
Marston.
Only folk around here call me Milton. It's kind of a joke, I guess.
A joke, huh? Which folk?
Mr. Getty's? Uh-huh. I work for him. He said that you could help me out. I mean, if you can.
So old David Getty's told you I'm the kind of man to loan a man with two names money so he can buy a rundown farm on account of his lack of farming skills, huh?
Don't sound too promising when you put it like that.
Well, how would you put it?
Sorry to waste your time, sir.
Oh, sit down. I'm sure we can figure something out. Now, of course, we'll be expecting you to make regular payments, and given a lack of much evidence you got any means of repaying, the terms won't be too great. But if my cousin vouches for you, it'll be okay with the bank.
Really?
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Now, of course, we'll be expecting our money back regular as clockwork until the debt's settled. Otherwise, the farm reverts to the bank, no matter how much you paid.
I understand.
Well, why don't you go check out the land while I fix the contracts and talk to Mr. Getty's. Oh, I heard there's squatters up there. We've been having so many problems recently, they'll need clearing on.
Sure.
Well, come back when you're done and we'll fix up the paperwork.
Hello, sir.
Okay.
Help you, friend?
I hope so. Who's in charge here?
No one, mister. This is a free country.
Now that I ain't so sure about. Listen, I'm buying this land. I'm afraid you guys are gonna have to go somewhere else.
Who's this? I ain't sure.
some fancy dang city boy says he owns this land. Or he's gonna.
Owns it?
That's what he says.
Okay. And how come we living here?
I ain't sure.
Get the hell out of here. This land belongs to me now.
Ain't nothing on this earth belongs to no one, partner.
Looks like you made your decision then, partner.
I'm gonna watch your bastard ass.
Not you, the man with two names and no past. Come on in. How'd you make out?
Well, let's just say there are no more squatters.
Okay. Well, I got your paperwork ready. Now, you sure about buying this place? It's really run down, and the price isn't too great.
I think it would mean a lot for my wife. At least mean I was listening to her.
Okay. Well, sign here and here. Now we own you, Mr. Marston, and we own Mr. Milton, too, and we own your property. But you can buy your freedom each week. Eventually, you will be a homeowner.
I understand.
Congratulations. You are now a real American, indebted and owned by the bank. I'm joking. They own me. They just own your property. Now, you can also use this line of credit for any home improvements you need to make, of course.
I can?
Sure. Be good, Mr. Marston. Welcome to home ownership. It's a beautiful thing. Let your wife know what to complain about. I'm just joking.
Well, it is you. Well, I never. I thought you was dead, boy. Dead.
Uncle?
The very same. Come here. I saw you going into the bank, and by the looks of things, you ain't robbed it.
I've gone straight.
Oh, bull crap.
No, for real. Well, I'm trying.
All these years, you ain't changed a bit. Maybe a little bit. I thought you was dead.
Not yet. Well, I got some things to take care
of. Oh, not a problem. I'll come too.
No, you don't have to.
Oh, I'm real sick, John. Lumbago. It's a slow and painful death, my brother.
Evidently.
Have a little pity, will you? Huh?
Come on, then.
All right. I'm ready, Marston. Come on.
Follow me.
Nothing better to do?
Where are we headed?
West!
West? Oh, ain't you a man of few words? I can see we're headed west. You know, speaking of monosyllables don't make you seem interesting.
It makes you seem stupid.
I don't care how I seem.
Well, now where west are we headed, you damn grunting fool?
This ranch, a ranch I bought just now.
Is that what you were doing in the bank? Spending all your money? Oh, the owner of a ranch in the armpit of West Elizabeth. Oh, my Lord.
Not that that's any of your concern, but I was in the bank borrowing the money.
Well, that's even worse. Yeah, you can run from a bounty, John. You can't run from a bank. Is Abigail there?
No. She's, her and Jack are waiting until I'm set up before joining me out here.
You mean she left you? Oh, I never thought she was a smart woman, but, you know, this makes me think maybe I was wrong.
No more of that. I just bought this place, and you're lucky I'm showing it to you and not looking for a place to bury you out here. This is it. Look at her.
Okay.
What do you think?
Why exactly did you buy this dump?
For Abigail?
Why? Is she an idiot?
No.
What were you thinking?
I don't know. She said she wanted it.
She ever seen it? What are we gonna farm here? Rocks?
We?
You don't have a hope here without a wise hand at the tiller.
Enough of that. Get out of here. On your way.
No. You're stuck with me. Seems I'm stuck with you. John, the rock farmer.
So, you think I'm an idiot?
No. I know you're an idiot.
Working hard?
It's the lumbago. If I overdo it, I'll get a relapse. It's very serious.
Get up or get out.
You can be so testy. What is it? Constipation?
Guess you're my proof I'll never quite outrun my sins.
You got so sanctimonious in your old age. No wonder she left you. It's like rooming with the King James Bible.
Get up!
Ow! I'm getting up. Oh, no, wait, what did I have to tell you? I went into town, and, I got a little drunk. Oh, shit! Well, we gotta go. We gotta go to Saint-Denis. Charles Smith is alive, I reckon.
Charles Smith alive? Really?
I reckon. Unless I dreamed it all, and by the sound of it, not doing too good neither.
Thank you.
on. Let's get off.
All right.
Back in Saint Denis. I never liked this place.
Me neither. All right. Let's go find that big sour bastard.
Sure. Let's split up.
Good idea. I'll take the saloons, you take the slum.
How about I take the saloons, and you take the slums? Here now!
What is your problem?
Bonjour. How can I help you today, sir?
Listen, you seen a big Indian fella?
Indian?
Yeah, a boxer.
No. Sorry, mister. No. Actually, yes. I think he's fighting, I believe. Fighting out behind Saint Saturnin.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
No problem. I think they might be starting soon. I would head along that way. Saint Saturnin.
Let's go, girl. Just beginning to enjoy some peace and quiet.
Ask that first barman I met, and he told me Charles was here.
Folks,
not one of
surprise,
life's great mysteries,
but
turns out.
A massacre, and you are a killer. We both know what you gotta do. I'm leaving now.
He don't know the half of it.
John? You're
I'm alive. So are you. So's he.
That's Uncle?
What are you doing?
I don't know. I'm alive.
Uncle thought maybe he was in some sort of trouble.
Kind of, just... I don't know. I'm throwing fights for a few dollars.
Throwing fights?
Sure.
And you like that?
Of course not.
So...
Let me go place a bet. Come on. Man, I thought you were dead.
Sure. Abigail's still alive, too, only she left me.
Excuse me. I'd like to place a bet.
On who?
On myself, to win. Lone Wolf.
How much?
All of this.
Okay. Funny thing, I pegged you for the favorite, but the odds just got real good. What about you, sir? A little wager on the wolf here? Real redskin brave.
Sure, I'm a fan of the wolf. Give me a bet on him.
Have I got a treat for you? An epic battle between the descendant of ancient warriors and a not-so-noble savage. On my left, a ferocious battler from the valleys, Simon of Wales. And on my right, an Injun Hercules. The savage, the untamable, the unbeaten, and dare I say unbeatable, Lone Wolf. You know how this works. No weapons, no forfeiting, no crying like a beaten child. Everything else goes. You win by knockout, you win by retirement, or you win by death. Let's have a good fight, boys. Let's keep it clean, but not so clean.
Looking slow, my ball.
Water! Hit him, Lone Wolf! Charles?
What is this?
Pretend he's Micah.
Or something.
Knock him out. Try and stay on your feet, you hear? You're fighting with a hand behind your back. Don't black out just yet. Oh.
What the hell?
Hit him, Charles.
Come on, Lone Wolf. Better get you the hell out of here.
Lone Wolf! Whoa! How? Made my month, but you also made some fellas mighty unhappy.
So it goes.
Here's your share, partner.
If we just made the bed, I said we
should. So you keen on staying around here or heading off with me and Uncle?
But, John, I haven't seen you two in years.
I know. But right now, my sense is you just need to lie low.
Where?
We got a little place up past Blackwater, in the high country.
Okay. I gotta grab my baggage. I booked a steamer heading upriver. That's why I was pretending to throw the fight.
Okay, boys. I'll meet you at the bridge outside Saint Denis.
What are you doing?
Just have a few errands to run.
You're useless.
I am a deep thinker.
Be quick.
Come on. This way. My bag's on the dockside. So, what happened?
You mean back then? Arthur helped me get out. Gave me a chance to live, I guess. You know that Arthur...
Sure. Word got to me up north, so I went back and buried him in Miss Grimshaw.
I had to run. If any of us had been found, we'd have...
Of course. I understand. He's where he would have wanted to be. A pretty hillside, facing the evening sun.
He gave me his satchel with some of his things in it. Remember that journal he always drew in? I got it. I'm a bit of a draftsman myself nowadays.
Well, he wasn't a good man. None of us were. But, maybe he was true to himself.
Him and his code. That pig-headed bastard. You get sick like that, I guess you gotta cling to something.
He was hoping to come out of it. Hope was about all he had left. Maybe all any of us have. Anyway, I heard all you were dead. Or I might have come looking.
And me, the same about you.
Dutch?
Who knows? Dead? Maybe? I'm not sure. I heard all kind of things, but one thing I know, he ain't around here. I ain't heard nothing real in years since, well, that time.
Nor me. Micah?
I hope that bastard's dead. You know, he was the one speaking to them agents.
What?
Putting them on us the whole time. Or since before I got off Sissica.
They picked up Strauss, the agents. Made a real mess of him. I heard he died in custody. Never said a word.
Guess some folk is strong in ways you can't see.
Everything that happened, all those deaths. Micah?
None of us is innocent in that. Dutch, least of all. But I don't think we would have had to make those calls. All that mayhem, if it wasn't for...
Okay.
Hold on.
What?
Careful.
Why?
Those are Guido Martelli's men.
Who?
He used to work for Angelo Bronte.
I've only been here an hour.
Hey! Come over here.
What now?
Well, you go left, I go right. On three.
Mm-hmm.
Three.
You couldn't have thrown that fight!
That's just one fight.
Evidently! What are those guns they have?
What? You don't have them in the high
fight? Here he does! Frightened!
Let's go. There's a wagon up there. I'll get my bag.
Okay.
Come on, John!
Okay.
Where was Uncle gonna meet us?
Over the bridge going out of town. West.
Hold on.
You son of a whore!
You see it? Any law?
Not yet.
Keep your eye out. Sandini ain't short on police.
I remember that. Only too well.
Anyone?
Good so far. The further we get from those gunshots, better chance we have. Of denying it, at least.
No, we can't get caught. Martelli has the police chief in his pocket. If they take us in, we won't get out of the interview room.
I don't want to get in a shootout over this. That's not the man I try to be anymore.
No, I don't want that either. You see anything?
I think we're clear.
If I ever want to go back... Remind me. I hate Saint-Denis.
Guido Martelli will happily remind you of that.
Give me some simple folk and wide open spaces. Speaking of simple...
John! Charles!
You boys been all getting up to no good?
Kind of. Been getting shot at.
Well... They weren't very good shots. Come on, let's head for home.